Hello everyone and welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayashree this side. Today I will be sharing a process tutorial on how to make a shadow box card using Dress My Craft's miniatures. Before we dive into the tutorial, please do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to get notified every time we upload a new video. So to begin with, I will be using the super cute Magical Unicorns pattern paper pack from Dress My Craft. This pattern paper is truly unique and has some really amazing unicorn designs. It has beautiful shades of blues, greens, pinks and yellows. All Dress My Craft pattern papers come with an extra 1-inch top which can be trimmed off and used later. These pattern papers are also very well coordinated with each other. So you can mix and match various pattern papers together to make your albums and other scrapbooking or mixed media projects. Now to make the shadow box, I have taken this design from the pack and trimmed off the extra 1 inch, making the paper of the size 12 by 12 inch. Using my Dress My Craft scoreboard and bone folder which comes along with it, I will be scoring at 1/2 inch, 1.5 inch, 2 inch and lastly at 3 inch marks. I will continue scoring on the same points on all four sides. Once done, I am now going to next score at 3.5 and 8.5 inch until the second scored line previously. I will repeat this on all four sides. Next, I am marking the area with a pencil which needs to be cut on all four corners. This area is the last scored line, then a cross line connecting the inner scored line, then again straight where the scoring ends. I will repeat the same marking on its adjacent side. This is the area which I will cut on all four corners. This way you can make any size shadow box. I am now speeding up the video to save time. Once all the corners are cut, I will fold along all the scored lines and burnish it well with the help of my Dress My Craft bone folder for smooth creasing. Here you can see how by folding all the sides, a shadow box comes into view. Now to adhere the sides of the shadow box, I will be using Dress My Craft's Ultimate Craft Glue. Since this glue is super tacky, I have made a cone from a plastic wrap for its easy and precision flow. I am going to apply glue on the outermost 1/2 inch scored area only. Now I will adhere this along the last innermost scored line. I will repeat this on all four sides to form my shadow box of 6 inch square size. Now to make the divisions in the box, I have cut heavyweight chipboard as per the size of my box along with some pattern paper strips in the same size. I am now going to adhere these pattern paper strips on both sides of the chipboard cutouts. I have also cut a piece of paper to fit in the background which I am now inking on the edges using the aged mahogany distress oxide ink. I am inking the edges of all the chipboard pieces as well to form a uniform and finished edge. I am adhering the background paper using Dress My Craft's Ultimate Craft Glue and the chipboard pieces using hot glue. While I adore my chipboard pieces, why don't you share some love with us by hitting the like button on this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to never miss the video from us again. Once everything is stuck properly, it is time to ready our miniatures to set them up in the box. To begin with, I am using the small cake stands base and Oreo birthday cake miniatures. I will fix it on the stand using hot glue. Next, I am taking a tub and filling it with some frosted sugar powder from Dress My Craft to give the ice effect, in which I will place the cute little Coke bottle miniatures. Next, I am using these miniature plates and placing the burgers in it. But before that, I am also using a small piece of tissue paper for plating. Dress My Craft has the widest variety of miniature accessories, which range from eatables to flowers to home decor. One can make any theme shadow box using these miniature accessories, as the possibilities are endless. Coming back to the shadow box, I am going to do the same for the miniature cupcakes and chocolate rolls. I used glossy accents to adhere everything in place, even the frosted sugar in the tub, along with Coke bottles. I have here now die cuts from the Magical Unicorns collection. I am choosing some die cuts which I want to use on my shadow box. You may also choose to buy the Magical Unicorns motif sheet if you prefer fussy cutting yourself. I am also using die cuts from Little Miracle collection. I am picking up this cute little baby trying to look at something. Next, using the Dress My Craft's classic doily die and black cardstock, I have die cut out some doilies from which I have cut out the center circle. I also plated a couple of big Oreo cookies from Dress My Craft. Now it's time to assemble it all together. I'm starting with the top right box, in which I am adhering the doily die cut using Dress My Craft's ultimate craft glue. Next, I'm using a die cut out from Little Miracle pack and adhering it with the help of 12mm 3D foam tape from Dress My Craft. I'm adding double layer of the foam tape to add more dimension. Next, I am adhering the clown miniatures with the plate of Oreos in their center. I am using hot glue to adhere all the miniatures in their places. Moving on to the bottom right box, I am adhering the Coke ice tub along with the plate of burgers. Then in the top left box, I am adhering a duck die cut with 3D foam tape in the background, along with cupcake plate and chocolate roll plate. Now in the bottom left box, I want to place my cake on the stand along with this baby die cut peeking at the cake. To do that, I am cutting a small thin strip of paper from the leftover trimming and making an L fold. I'm adhering one side of the strip on the back of the baby die cut and the other side of the strip on the base of the box, giving it a standing support. Finally, adhering the cake on the stand. Doesn't this look super cute? I'm also adding a unicorn on the bottom right side of the box and a baby with a cake die cut behind the cake miniature to add some more interest in the background. Using these miniatures and working with them in your projects is real fun. No matter if you are a beginner or have been crafting from years, these miniatures are super easy to work with. Not just that, these can be used in any and every type of crafting, whether it is card making, scrapbooking layouts, albums, mixed media and whatnot. Next, I am creating a bunting on top of the box using Dress My Craft's white satin cord and some triangular pieces I cut from the pattern paper itself. I am simply using the ultimate craft glue from Dress My Craft to adhere it. I am going to make the bunting on both the sides. Once stuck properly, I am using the microfine glitter powder from Dress My Craft to add some shimmer on the clouds die cuts. I am applying some craft glue on the cloud area and then dipping them directly into the powder jar. These Dress My Craft jars are very cute and easy to use with the big opening just like this. I am now dabbing off the excess and adhering it on the either side on the top of the box. Here our box is ready. Let's make the card fold for this now. To make the card, I have here a piece of same pattern paper as my shadow box, cut in the size 6 by 7.5 inches. Using Dress My Craft scoreboard and bone folder, I am going to score at 6 and 6.5 inch on the 7.5 inch line. After folding along the scored lines and creasing it well, I will now take the last 1 inch scored area and apply glue on the white side of the paper and adhere it on the left side of the box. Here our shadow box card base is ready. Let's take a look at the complete card. I have used some flowers and chipboard sentiment along with unicorn die cuts on the front of the card, keeping it simple. I have also created a small tuck spot using a note card from the pattern paper on the inside of the card. I hope you liked this creation and are inspired to make one of your own using the wide variety of miniatures Dress My Craft has to offer. Also, do not forget to like and share this video with your fellow crafters and friends. Last but not the least, don't forget to subscribe the channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to never miss any video from us again. Until next time, happy crafting! Bye-bye!